Thanks for tuning in. I'm Margaret Hunter Wade, and you're watching Cox Connections only on Cox 9. The Roanoke and Blacksburg regions often market themselves separately, but a new organization has dedicated itself to connecting the regions to bolster the combined economic potential through innovation. Jonathan Witt, the executive director of Roanoke Blacksburg Innovation Network, is here to tell us more. Thanks for being here today.
Well, thank you for having me.
It's very good to see you, and an interesting concept for the Roanoke Blacksburg Innovation Network, a new organization to the area. So if you don't mind, just start off telling us what it is.
Sure.
And how you got started.
I'm happy to. So the Roanoke Blacksburg Innovation Network is a new nonprofit organization that's dedicated to building an innovation ecosystem across the region. So what that means is that we live in this 21st century global economy where innovation and talent and entrepreneurial culture all matter. And it's unique that this region has, in our belief, a lot of the key ingredients that we need to succeed into the future. We have probably more colleges and universities per capita than any other place that are providing access to talent, top-tier research. We have a thriving technology community. And then you add on top of that this amazing quality of place. And we believe that this region has huge potential for growth over the next decade and beyond.
So untapped potential that you're going to tap. So the mission of the organization, really, at the end of the day, what are y'all hoping to achieve?
Yeah, well, what we hope to achieve is the growth of lots more technology and innovation-focused companies. We have this big goal that we've sort of hung out there for ourselves to say, we'd like to say at the end of 3 years that we've helped to create 100 new companies, attracted $50 million in venture capital, and created at least 500 new jobs. And it's not necessarily that, you know, we're going to take this direct credit for us doing this. If you weren't involved with the Innovation Network, it wouldn't have happened. But it's a true network node organization where we're really working with individuals and organizations across the region that share the same goals that we have.
Right.
And they're taking on specific activities that are going to help us get there.
Okay. No small feat, but I'm sure you're poised to do it.
Yeah.
So far, what successes have you seen? What have you accomplished? What can you kind of tout to date?
Yeah. So I guess I'll kind of back into that and say it's probably should explain the four areas that we're working a little bit better.
Yeah.
So there are really core four things that we're doing. We call them the core four. And that is, first of all, focus on developing this entrepreneurial culture in the region that's focused on the growth of these high impact and high tech companies. And the reason we're really focused there on those type of companies is because on average they're creating jobs, they're bringing in direct capital investment, they're also making capital investment back into the community, they have high growth potential, and so we're focused there. And we're doing that by focusing on access to capital, mentoring services, new environments for these type of companies to start up and be nurtured across the Roanoke and New River Valleys. The second area is connecting industry and startups and entrepreneurs to the universities. So there's amazing potential there for folks to connect with research and development, commercialization opportunities, and then just really for the colleges to find placement for a lot of their students.
Right.
The third area is really focused on talent. So that's one of the key ingredients in our region's economy, and really all the economies around the United States right now. We're really focused on talent development. So for us, how do we get more students involved in STEMH, we call it, science, technology, engineering, math, and healthcare, because those are really the foundational things that we believe this region's economy are going to continue to grow upon. So how do we focus more energy there?
Right.
How do we recruit? So how do we say this is an amazing place to come and work if you're upper level technical talent or upper level management talent? And then the fourth one is market. So tell the story really well that you need to be here. Roanoke and the New River Valleys are amazing places to be. Come, live, and be a part of what we're doing here. So
absolutely. Yeah, I agree. So. All sounds good to me. So So with all of that being said, accomplishments to date.
Yeah, so accomplishments to date, the good news is in just a few short months, we've raised about $17 million.
All right.
That's towards that $50 million goal, and we've already made two investments in local companies to start to further this development of venture capital and seed capital in the region. We have seen the launch of new spaces, both in Roanoke and Blacksburg, that are hubs for ideation and startups. So that's been very important. We've mapped all of the STEM-H, K-12 STEM-H programs in the region. We've also mapped as many of the companies that we could find that are in this high impact space. So we've began to pull together these resources and start the dialogue with folks who are on the front lines to say, you know, how do we increase our capacity? How do we work together to grow this across the region?
So. That's great. And in just a couple of months, I mean, that's amazing that there's obviously an appetite.
That's
so
right.
Folks that are interested in getting involved with your organization, folks that say, I've got an idea, or hey, I've got a business that I'd love to have funded. What's the next steps for them?
Yeah, well, they're welcome to go to our website and just sign up for our newsletter. So that would be a good first step. Our role is really, in a lot of ways, to refer them out to the people who are on the front lines. So if you look across the region, you know, we're working with economic development folks, chambers of commerce, SBDC, private consultants even. And we really like to get them plugged in to where we think it makes best sense for them. So that would really be the first step to get connected with us.
So you've just got lots of information, and you're just connecting people all over the place with the right folks.
Yeah, really we are. And I think that's really the right first step. Before you can start to build sustainable programs, we'll say, we need to pull the assets together and say, you know, let's make sure everybody's talking and we know what each other's doing, and we're working really well together.
Well, it sounds like you're off to a great start, and I wish you and the organization the best of luck and appreciate your coming in today.
Good. Well, thank you for having me.
Absolutely. To learn more about the Roanoke Blacksburg Innovation Network, visit them on the web or give them a call at the number on your screen. Before you go, I want to personally thank you for choosing Cox Communications for your entertainment, information, and communication needs. We know you could have chosen another provider, but because you chose us, we promise to provide you with quality products backed up by a talented local team of professionals. I'm Margaret Hunter-Wade, and we'll see you next time on Cox Connections.